When you hear the word ministry, what do you think of? Do you think of what the pastor does? Do you think that's what the church does? Is it what people actually go to Bible college to learn how to do? Well, today we're going to be talking about the word ministry and what it really means coming up. Welcome back to Cheers, where we have one clear goal, and that's to help you love God, love others, and bear the fruit of the Spirit to a hurting world. If you're new with us, welcome to our Cheers community. And today, we're going to be talking about, for our group discussions, the word ministry. And when you think of the word ministry, what do you think of? Is it literally something the pastor does or the church staff does? I know when I was felt like I was called into ministry at age 17, I thought, wow, okay, now I've got to go to Bible college to learn how to do ministry. You know, it seemed like for the first 300 years, the body of Christ actually did the work of ministry, where the disciples, you and I and every Christian out there, we were the ones that were actually doing the work of ministry. Why did that responsibility actually transfer to clergy in a sense? And how do we actually get that back? Now, Ephesians 4 verses 8 says, therefore, he says, when he ascended on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts to men. So point number one that we want to talk about in this discussion on the word ministry is know your role. Know your role. So verse 11 in Ephesians 4 says, and he gave himself some to be apostles, prophets, evangelists, and some pastors and teachers. And, you know, we look at those as the fivefold ministry gifts, meaning that when you're called to be an apostle or a prophet or evangelist or a pastor or a teacher, you're called into ministry. But if you're not actually called to be one of those five, then you're not actually called into the ministry. You might believe that you are to minister, but you're not actually believing that you're called into the ministry, as if the ministry was defined by those five ministry gifts. Now, apostles are usually those who start ministries. They work with leaders to keep the ministry going, but usually they're on the go. Prophets, those who relay the word of the Lord to the people. Evangelists are those who primarily spend their time sharing the gospel with the lost of the community or the city or wherever they're at. They're usually on the go as well. Pastors, those are primarily people who spend their time caring for Christians. Now, obviously, they can talk to unbelievers and share the gospel as well, but primarily, pastors are spending their time caring for Christians or caring for the sheep. And pastor, it represents the word shepherd as well. And they usually stay in one place. And then teachers are those who primarily teach Christians. And they usually stay in one place as well. Sometimes, though, there obviously can be teachers that travel. And verse 12 says, the reason why these gifts have been given is for the equipping of the saints for the work of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. Now, that's the why behind this these giftings. But notice in verse 12, it says, for the equipping of the saints. That's the believers. That's every Christian out there, the saints, the body of Christ, for the work of ministry. Notice that it actually talks about ministry is what the saints do, the believers do, the body of Christ does. And why do they do that? For the edifying of the body of Christ. So it's for edification. So saints and Christians are to be equipped for ministry. It's how the body of Christ is actually edified. And then all Christians are working in ministry, not just pastors or prophets or teachers or the evangelists. So now verse 13 kind of tells us how long this process is supposed to be. Till we all come to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God, to the perfect man, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Now, that means we're going to be doing this forever, because it will take us forever to come to the unity of faith and the knowledge of the Son of God, to be a perfect and complete man, to the measure and stature of the fullness of Christ. So now verse 14 it says that we should no longer be children. So this is the purpose of the equipping and the work of ministry, that we should no longer be children, tossed to and fro, carried about by every wind of doctrine, by the trickery of men and the cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting, but speaking the truth in love, may actually grow up in all things in him who is the head, Christ, for whom the whole body, joined and knit together, listen to this, by what every joint supplies. You and I represent those joints and ligaments that hold the body of Christ together. And we are knit together and joined by what every joint supplies. So what you supply each other. So as we minister to each other, we are causing our body to be joined and knit together and for edification and for the effecting work by which every part does its share, what causes growth of the body for the edifying itself. So that we don't say stay spiritual children, but that we grow up in Christ. This is one of the reasons why God wants us to be equipped and to be doing the work of ministry, edifying the body of Christ, and so that we are knit together by what every part does it supplies and does it share, so that we can grow up in love. Now, I was called into ministry when I was 17. And again, it's that thing that you feel like is that aha moment. I was down at the altar and I felt like the Lord said, preach to me. I was 17. I had no idea, ever heard the word of the Lord before. I went to my pastor and I said, hey, I think I've been called to preach. He says, well, it's not something you want to rush into. Just put it on the shelf. And if God really wants it to happen, he'll bring it about. So I did. And I went back to my worldly ways and just put it on the shelf. And then God did bring that back around when I was 18, the senior in high school at that point, a year later. And he began to just work on me and deal with me about ministry. So, but it was interesting that when I was called into ministry, and then I went to Bible college a couple years later to learn how to do ministry. And then it's funny because I had to relearn after 5 years of Bible college, I had to relearn and learn how to equip others to do ministry. See, Ephesians 4 says that pastors are to equip the saints to do the work of ministry. And I felt called to be a pastor. So I went to Bible college to learn how to do. And when I got out, I started doing ministry. And then the Lord just woke me up one night. It was like, I've called you to equip the saints to do the work of ministry. And I'm like, well, I just went to 5 years of Bible college to learn how to do it. I don't know how to equip others to do it. I just know how to get in there and put my hands to the plow and do it. And, but the Lord started giving me an analogy. You know, it was kind of like I couldn't, if you think about a football field or a football analogy, I was on the field. I was taking snaps and I was, you know, running the plays. And the Lord said, look, I'm calling you off of the field and onto the sidelines to coach. So I couldn't play on the field anymore. I actually had to coach from the sidelines, but I still had to accomplish the same things. And man, I remember, you know, my first pastoring job, and I was put in charge of a few ministry teams, and there was a leader that wasn't really doing so well. So I pushed him out of the way kind of and said, oh, I'll jump in here and I'll just do it myself because I can get it better, do it better myself in a sense. And that's when the Lord really started dealing with me about, no, Lee, you're not to push the players off to the side and jump in there and do it yourself. It's kind of like a coach that, you know, the quarterback's messing up a little bit. So the coach pulls the quarterback out, puts him on the sidelines, and then the coach goes in and takes the snaps and plays as the quarterback. Well, we know that doesn't work. So you're either a coach or you're a player. And the Lord was saying, Lee, I want you to not be a player on the field, but I want you to coach and equip the players on the field. And so it was difficult for me to do that because I had to learn my role. My role was an equipper. And now I had done plenty of volunteering and I had done plenty of ministry, but then God changed that. And, you know, sometimes we even see it in the regular football analogy. Again, there a lot of coaches were players first. So they know how to do ministry. They know how to do play on the field. They understand the game, and now God's calling them to coach. And so it's the same way in ministry. Sometimes, you know, we're out there doing the work of ministry, but then God calls us to actually now become equippers to help others do the work of ministry. So I had to learn my role. And so do you know your role? Are you a spiritual coach? Are you a leader in the kingdom and or a player? And we all, you know, the good thing about all of this is that we're all on the field doing something for God. So within Cheers, if you're called to coach or equip, then you need people to do that with. And that means you're a leader. And to lead, you need followers. And to get followers, you start groups. And we've started Cheers groups, and we put leaders in those places. And those leaders are equippers, and they'll be equipping the saints to do the work of ministry. And because leaders coach, leaders equip, leaders lead. So ministry is what the saints do. It edifies the body of Christ. And equipping is what leaders do. They equip the saints to do ministry. So for me, I'd spent 35 years in ministry, and literally only 9 years of that 35 years of ministry was actually full-time ministry, about 25%. And 26 years of that 35 was actually volunteering or serving in the church. So, you know, we're all on the field. We're all on the football field. Some are players, some are coaches, but none are called to watch in the stands. Nobody is called to watch in the stands. You're either playing or you're coaching. You're doing ministry and working in ministry, or you're equipping others to do ministry. So point number two here is, what is ministry? Defining that. So point two is, ministry is edifying the body of Christ. Ministry is edifying the body of Christ. So in verse 12, it says, for the equipping of the saints to do the work of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. Now, the reason we equip the saints for ministry is so that they can edify, right? So the word ministry just simply means to serve in the Greek. And the word edify is to build up, as if like a construction to actually build. And we see this very practically speaking, where the general disciples were actually in the ministry, where we see Luke 10:40 is the story of Mary and Martha. Most of you can understand that Martha was actually doing a lot of work, and Mary was sitting at the foot of Christ. And Mary got upset about that, or Martha got upset about that. So in Luke 10:40 says, but Martha was distracted with much serving. That word serving there is the Greek word for ministry. So here Martha was distracted by much ministry, and she approached him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to minister alone? Therefore, tell her to help me. So ministry, what she was doing was edifying. But I wanted to bring that scripture in because the word serving there is the word ministry. And so helping to identify who ministers in the body of Christ. Is it just pastors? Is it just prophets? Is it just apostles? Or is it everybody? And we see here, Martha was literally in ministry, and she was doing ministry because ministry was edifying the body of Christ. So are you called to edify the body of Christ? Yeah, sure you are. Then you are called to ministry. So 1 Corinthians 14:26, how is it then, brethren, when you come together, each of you has a psalm, a teaching, a tongue, has a revelation, has interpretation, let all things be done for what? Edification. 1 Corinthians 8:1 says, knowledge puffs up, but love edifies. Ephesians 4:29, let no corrupt word proceed out of your mouth, but what is good for necessary edification, that it may impart grace. And so how do we do ministry? How do we edify? So if, you know, I want you to know that you are called into the ministry. It's not just a calling for prophets and pastors and teachers in that fivefold. They are to equip, but all saints, all believers are called into ministry. So how do we do ministry? Or how do we edify? Well, a couple easy ways to look at that is we edify by the things we say, and we also edify by the things that we do. So the things that we say are a face-to-face, a phone call, a text message, an email, a letter, just edifying the body of Christ. So when you think about somebody, you think about a friend, you think about somebody, a member of your church, you literally just send them a text, say, hey, I was thinking about you. How are you doing? Just wanted to encourage you with a scripture, maybe, type out a little scripture there and just say, I'm praying for you today. That edifies, that ministers to one another. And that is ministry. How about also we edify by the things we do? So like running an errand, helping with a task, cooking for someone, giving gifts, actually offering opportunities for fellowship. So our groups offer opportunity for fellowship that you can come and you can attend and you can be a part of a fellowship there, but also part of something bigger that's actually ministering out into the community in the city on a regular basis. We had one of our members actually invited everyone over for pie and on a Saturday afternoon. It was fantastic. That was ministry. She was offering an opportunity for fellowship and to get together. And we were able to begin to speak to one another. We prayed for one another, and it was just a good time. And so doing ministry is actually pretty simple. We just have to get out of the stands, right, and onto the field and edify. So let me recap here. Point number one is know your role. Point number two is ministry is simply edifying the body of Christ. So now let me give you a few discussion questions here that may help you in your group discussion today. Number one, did this discussion change your mind of or view of what ministry is? Number two, do you now see that we are all called into the ministry? Number three, do you see that we all have a role to play on the field? Number four, do you know your role? And number five, what are some examples when you felt edified by someone? How did that make you feel? So as always, I want you to love God, love others, bear the fruit of the Spirit to a hurting world. And I want to thank you for joining us today. My name is Lee West, pastor of Cheers Church, and we hope you just have a fantastic discussion today. God bless.